Hi, hello, and welcome to a new YouTube video. So in this video, you'll see my stretching journey on how I got to this size. Well, not this size, because this is an 18mm. You'll see how I got to a double zero gauge, which is 10mm. There are some mishaps and some mistakes in this video, in this journey. Sometimes I only waited a week or two until I stretched my ears. You should not do that, because that fucks up your ears. Yeah, just look at them. You. Since then, I've taken care of them and been way more safe about how I stretch them. It took me about 6 months to stretch them to a 10mm, and that's kind of fast. You know, wait at least a month until you stretch your ears. Remember to stretch safe. Okay, enjoy the video. Today I'm gonna stretch my ear. I'm gonna stretch this ear. Kinda excited, kinda very nervous. So here's the 12 gauge taper I'm gonna use to stretch my right ear. Gonna use coconut oil. Many people use e-oil, but I find coconut oil a little bit better. Before I remove the piercing, I just put coconut oil on the taper to make it go in better. This is literally lube for ears. So this is the only action I've gotten in the last few months. Okay, it's in. Okay, you see it? You see it? Okay, good. So I'm gonna let it sit for about 20 minutes, maybe half an hour. It still hurts, but the pain is like a roller coaster. That was really poetical. That's life. That's life. The pain has passed. And I think it's gonna work out quite okay. Okay, so it's been half an hour, and I'm gonna put this gouge. I always say it wrong. I'm gonna put this in the gouge. First, I have to butter it up with coconut oil. I'm just gonna put it in while the paper is like drifting. I don't know if that makes sense, but you know, you'll see. Worked. Ta-da! There we have it. I'm pretty happy with it. I don't remember if I said it's a 12 gauge. I think I already said that. Today I'm gonna stretch this ear from a 10 gauge to a 8 gauge. So I washed this with like antibacterial soap. Now I'm gonna dip it in coconut oil. We just lube it up. So the last time I tried to stretch this to an 8 gauge, because I've had a piercing there for years, and it's always been, or it was pretty like big before I started stretching it anyway, so I was like, I'm gonna try this. But it didn't work, so I had to go use a 10 gauge. Now, I hope, I pray to God. So I'm gonna take this one out, the 10 gauge. Then, right after, it's stretched. I'm gonna put this in. That went in there quite easily. I feel a slight sting, but it doesn't hurt, you know. You know. Strange, I didn't think it would go in that easily. I guess that's good. So I'm gonna let it sit in there for about 20 minutes, and then I'm gonna change to the gauge. So I'm back. It's been 20 minutes or more. I ate a good pizza. I'm ready to put the gauge in. I washed it with antibacterial soap, and now I'm just gonna lube it up with coconut oil. Ew. There's something coconut oil in it. Then I'ma just slide it through while I'm pulling the taper out. feel my hands are so oily and greasy. I guess this is the bad side of using coconut oil. Well, do you get oily from e-oil too? I've never tried it, TBH. Huh, and it's in. Ta-da! And it doesn't hurt, like, at all. And this is smaller than this, but, and it'll be that way for a while, till I reach my goal size, which is a 0-0 gauge. So today I'm gonna stretch this ear to a 6 gauge, currently at a 8. I'm ready to stretch it farther. The first thing I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna dip this in the coconut oil, and I'm gonna take this one out. Like that. It's true. It stings quite a bit. I'm just gonna leave this in for half an hour and then we're gonna put the gauge in. Hi, I'm back. Don't mind the cap. Ooh, that rhymes. My hair is a mess after I've showered and it gets poofy. But anyways, it's been half an hour and I'll try to put the gauge in. I'll just lube the gauge with coconut oil. I hope this works. Please, let this work. Okay. Removing the plastic thingy. Push this through while the taper is sliding out. It worked! Finally, thank God, it worked. So now I put the plastic thingy back on the back of it so it won't boop, you know, slide out. It stings, just a little. I'm really happy it worked this time, because it's really frustrating when it won't go in. If you're stretching your ears, you can relate. Today I'm gonna stretch this ear to a 4 gauge. I'm currently at a 6 and it's been almost a month and I'm ready to stretch it. I'll dip the taper in coconut oil. Gotta love that greasy feeling of coconut oil. Now that we've greased up the taper, I'll take out the 6 gauge and I'll also smear this with some coconut oil and there we go. It's in, it stings just a little, but I'll leave it in for about 30 minutes I think. It's been like 30 minutes or so and I'm gonna put the gauge in while the taper is sliding out. And I've also put coconut oil on the gauge. Okay. It's in. It worked. I'm happy. And then I'll just put this plastic thingy on the back of it so it doesn't slide out all of a sudden. So today I'm gonna be stretching this ear to a 2 gauge. I have the taper right here. I'm currently at a 4 gauge. Now it's time to stretch it farther. So first thing I'll do is I'll dip it in coconut oil. And then I'll remove the 4 gauge. Like that. And then it's time to put the taper in. I have my mirror here and I'm ready. Like that. It stings a little bit, but I mean, I can deal with it. I'll leave this in for 20 minutes and I'll be right back. I'm back and it's been about 20 minutes. This camera is... But anyways, it's time to put the gauge in. I put coconut oil on the gauge so it's ready to slide in. And here we go. And it's in. Oh yeah, I'll just put the rubber band on the back. Okay, so in this video I'll be stretching this ear to a 0 gauge. It's currently at a 2 gauge and it's been almost a month, and I'm ready to stretch it. I'll just go ahead and dip it in coconut oil. Just mirror it up. It's greasy AF, but you know, yeah. There we go. And I'll just take this gauge out. Ooh, you can like see through it. I mean, what else do you expect when you're stretching your ear? And let's go. Okay, so I got it in off camera and it stings. Just a little, as you can tell. I'll leave it in for half an hour and I'll try to get the gauge in. Hopefully it will. See you in 30 minutes. Hello, I'm back. And it's been 40 minutes and I'm ready to put the gauge in. I already oiled it up with coconut oil, but why not just put on some more Prain, that will work. Yeah, so let's do this. So I'll just put the gauge in while the taper is sliding out. The end of the gauge just won't go through. So I got it in once again off camera, but it's in and I'm happy. I was determined to get it in, so can't stop, won't stop. In the words of Miles Harrison, we can't stop, well, and we won't stop, no. Don't take nothing from nobody, yeah, yeah. It stings a little bit, but you know, life hurts, man. Life hurts. So I'll just clean this with this piercing cleaning thing I bought at the pharmacy. So in this video, I'll be stretching this ear to a 0 gauge. It's currently at a 2 gauge. And I tried stretching it to a 0 gauge like a month ago, but it just wouldn't go. So I'm going to stretch it now and I know I'm ready because, or my ear is ready because I can do this. Look, there it is. And there it's out. So I have my coconut oil. And I'll just mirror the taper up with coconut oil. Let's go. And it's in. It stings a bit. It doesn't sting as much this time as it did a month ago. But a month ago I stretched it like a week after I stretched it the last time, you know. So that was fun. Don't recommend it. Wait a month and put a little more coconut oil on the gauge and just put it up like that while the taper is sliding out. And we're true. Yeah, so now I'm just gonna put the plastic thingy back on it and remember which one's which. But hoping it's this one. That's a 0 gauge. Went from this to this. That's glow up though. In this video, I'll be stretching my ear up to a 0 gauge, which is 10 millimeters. It's been long over a month since I stretched it the last time, so here's the taper. I have to use Vaseline for this because I don't have my coconut oil available right now. I'm just gonna, you know, put Vaseline on the taper thingy, you know. I'll just take this one out like that. See? So I'm just massaging the lobe with a little bit of Vaseline. I would have done it with coconut oil, but you know, it's not here. She's not here. I don't know her. Stretching.
it's a lot of work. Here's the taper, and just gonna slide it through the ear, like this. It stinks a little bit, but you know, what else do you expect when you're stretching up to a 10mm? I think I'll leave this in for 20 minutes, and I'll be right back. I'm back, and it's been about 20 minutes now. I washed this with antibacterial soap. Now I got soap on my hands. Now I'll remove the plastic rubber band. I mean, rubber is plastic. Yeah, you know what I mean. I'm just gonna slide this from the taper through while the gauge is filling its place, literally. I'm so funny, you know? But yeah. And it's in with like literally no trouble at all. I have to wash the rubber band with soap to get off any evil bacteria and, you know, demons and stuff, because we don't want any demons in our ears. I'm just gonna put it in on the fucking back if it will fucking fit. Yep. And then, let's just, while I'm on camera, let's just clean this stretched ear, you know? You have to clean it with the antibacterial wound cleaning once or twice a day. But yeah.
Yeah. That was my stretching journey. Now I got to 10mm. Suddenly I can't speak. 10mm is the ears. My fucked up ears are impacting my speech. But yeah. I'll do another video on how I'll take care of them if you want to. They look pretty okay now. They're healthy. Thank God. They're not ripped. I'll take way more care of them now, and so should you. Hope you liked the video. If you liked it, remember to like and subscribe and all that stuff. And yeah, stretch safe.